This summer, we started an occasional series called Musiconomy, which looks at some of the many ways music impacts the region's economy. Today, WXXI's Brenda Tremblay introduces us to a local entrepreneur who is launching a service for musicians that is inspired by YouTube.
Psychologist and businessman Tim Enright got the idea for the new service in the middle of a cello lesson.
I've been taking cello lessons for a couple of years from Diego Garcia at Eastman Community Music School, and he is full of so much important information that I really wanted to try to capture it, and I found that I was having some trouble remembering everything he was saying when I sat down to the cello at home to practice, so much so that at times it would inhibit me from practicing out of fear of picking up bad habits.
Enright wanted a way to capture his lesson so he could watch it again and again later while he was practicing at home. That's when the light bulb went off.
In the middle of one of my lessons, I realized he has a computer sitting right on his desk. I know he has internet connection because he shows me YouTube videos of other performers to help me learn more about how to interpret music. All that was needed is a webcam and some software.
So about a year and a half ago, Enright hired a couple of developers and created Virtuoso TV, an internet service designed specifically for musicians. The idea is this. A student walks into a lesson, and the teacher clicks on record on the computer, which is already set up with a camera and quality microphone. The program videotapes the music lesson and then automatically sends it to the Virtuoso TV website where the student can watch it anytime, anywhere, to review important tips and play along.
When you record yourself, the thing that you find is many things are better than you thought. And many things that you thought were fine, it surprises you to see, oh, am I really doing that? Ooh, okay, let me work on that this week.
Corrine Stone teaches string players in her home studio in Rochester.
The thing that's going to do that, if you really open your arm all the way. You want to try one more time? But really focus on whole bows this time. That can be homework for you. Really the whole thing, whole bows. Thirds and arpeggio too, okay? Okay, I'm going to put a chapter mark in your lesson.
When Tim first told me about the program, I said, well, am I going to see my student on YouTube and have their mom crying at me? Why is this broadcast?
That was her main concern. Other teachers, she says, might worry that such a service would infringe on their intellectual property.
You wouldn't want someone to take that and then start selling your lessons, you know, or just sharing them. I mean, it's kind of like burning a CD or copying software.
But Tim Enright, the founder of Virtuoso TV, designed it so that only users with a password can see their own videos. That's unlike YouTube, where most everything is open to most everyone. The other crucial difference is the time frame. YouTube limits users to 15 minutes or less. Virtuoso TV, or VTV as Enright calls it, lets teachers record up to 3 hours nonstop.
Make sure you have your best violin hold. Can you make sure also that your wrist is a little straighter, Mark? Good. Make sure your pinky's strong. That looks really good.
Corrine Stone says about 75% of her students use VTV. Two of them are a father and son, Mark and Damian Creason. 8-year-old Mark has been studying violin since he was 3. After his lesson, he goes home and watches and listens again on a laptop.
Sometimes for the scales, I listen, then I play. Sometimes I play with. And sometimes I just go in, watch it. Play, go back in, watch it, go play.
Yeah, we can skip around with bookmarks. So we'll frequently do something, and if we get to the end and say, oh, well, let's, we're going to move on to something else, we put a bookmark there. So then, say, Kareem plays a scale for one of us, and we can listen to that. We know where that scale is, and you can go right to that and listen to that part. Maybe only do that today.
Remember this one, we're thinking of push off and
push
coast.
Off and coast.
So that you're getting a sound that has more emphasis on the beginning of the stroke. Right. Actually, why don't you should take a couple open string strokes. Right. And then the one other thing, Damien, actually trade me spots just so this goes in your video. If you can make sure there's a difference between coasting.
Damien Creason began taking viola lessons last year. He says VTV has helped him get to the point where he's able to play with his son in a community orchestra, the Kaleidoscope Orchestra, at the Eastman Community Music School.
I'm very new to any kind of music, so being able to hear what's going on, hear what my scale is really supposed to sound like, watch particularly what my hand is supposed to look like, what my position is supposed to look like when I'm doing it. Not just looking at, say, what it's supposed to be in somebody else. So it can be used a whole bunch of different ways. It's really very useful.
His teacher says she doesn't have to repeat herself during lessons as much as she used to. And sometimes she'll ask a student to go back and review a lesson from months before. All of the lessons are stored indefinitely. According to Stone, it's a valuable tool for her most advanced students.
It is really important for them to have an efficient technique if they want to cover a lot of music, because they're not just studying music. They have to be good students, and they have to have jobs, a lot of them, and do a lot of things. So if I can record something for them two ways, and they can not just see but also hear the difference that produces, that's really crucial.
VTV founder Tim Enright is just getting the service off the ground. He says he has about 100 instructors set up to record lessons at the Eastman School, Hochstein, and in various private studios. VTV is free for teachers, but their students pay a modest monthly fee to use it. So far, Enright says he has about 50 paying customers. He's not ready to give up his private practice as a psychologist, but he has big hopes for the future.
For the academic year 2011-2012, the sky's the limit. We want to make Virtuoso TV available in multiple countries. We want to start connecting students from all over the world.
Enright is hoping to cover his startup costs soon. He says he's not thinking about other applications at this point. He's just focused on music. He's passionate about it, and he wants his new service to fuel other people's passion, too.
That report from WXXI's Brenda Tremblay is the latest in WXXI's Musiconomy series.